Hello friends, so in this lecture we are going to study how to use quarter wave transformer to match any load. So what is quarter wave transformer? Quarter means lambda, quarter means 1 by 4 and wave means wavelength. So if you have any length which is equal to lambda by 4 is called quarter wavelength. So what is the beauty of this quarter wavelength? If I take a transmission line having length lambda by 4 and load is ZL and we calculate input impedance, then what we will get? The input impedance will be equal to Z0 ZL plus J Z0 tan beta L. So if L is lambda by 4, beta L will be 2 pi by lambda into lambda by 4, which is equal to pi by 2. So 10 pi by 2, and here it is Z0 plus JZL 10 pi by 2. We know that 10 pi by 2 is infinite, so you will divide by 10 pi by 2 in numerator and denominator. And we will get Z0, ZL divided by 10 pi by 2, which is infinity. So this component is 0. So you will have Z0 here in the numerator, JZ0 by JZL, which can be written as Z0 square by ZL. So your input impedance is Z0 square by ZL. So the characteristic impedance Z0 is under root Zin into ZL. So if your transmission line is lambda by 4 length long and the load impedance is ZL and the input impedance is Zin, then the characteristic impedance of this transmission line will be the geometric mean of input impedance and the load impedance, provided the load impedance is purely resistive. So this should be purely resistive, means it will be in the form of RL plus J0. So these properties can be used to match any load with the line. So for that we'll be taking the Smith chart. Okay, and in this Smith chart we can identify the load value. Let us say our load value for this problem is ZL is equal to 50 plus 70 J ohm and Z0 is 50 ohm. So our normalized load will be equal to 50 plus 70 divided by 50, that is 1 plus 1.4 J. So this is our normalized load. Now we have to find 1 plus 1.4 J on the Smith chart. So this is our R equal to 1 circle. Okay, so we'll move on R equal to 1 circle, and then also we'll find 1.4 J. So this is reactance circle which is having 1.4 value. So this is my point in circle 8, and then draw a straight line from the center of Smith chart. So we'll draw the straight line from center, this passing through the load point, and we'll extend it to the outside. So now we'll check what is the cutting point here. It is 0.173 lambda. So we'll note that 0.173 lambda. And then we will use compass to draw constant VSWR circuit. So this is how we can use compass for drawing constant VSWR circle. We'll start from the center, we'll take up to this point, and we'll draw the circle. So this is our constant VSWR circuit. Now, wherever it is cutting, this circle is cutting at the real axis. That means the R equal to this on this axis, the impedance is purely real. So this point we will highlight. So first point is here and another point is here. So it will give you two solutions. Take either, so let us take the first one, which is wherever it is cutting the first point, we'll take. So this is our movement, means we are moving on constant VSWR circle. The first point is cutting at 3.6. So the cutting point is 3.6. And here you will see what is the value of lambda. It is 0.25 lambda. 0.25 lambda. So if we have a load given as 50 + 70 J Ω, then if I choose a length of 0.25 lambda minus 0.173 lambda, that is the length we have to move to get the pure resistive value. So if I move from the load towards the generator by this distance, means 0.25 lambda minus 0.173 lambda. If you calculate, you will get 0 - 3 = 7, 4 - 14 - 7 = 7, and then 0. So 0.077 lambda, means this is 0.077 lambda. If you move this much length, then you will get the pure resistive value. So the input impedance at this point can be calculated as 3.6 multiplied by 50. 50 ohm is the characteristic impedance of the line. So if you multiply, you will get the actual value of input impedance, that is 180 ohm. Now input impedance is 180 ohm here, which need to be converted to an input impedance of 50 ohm. So we'll be using a transmission line which is lambda by 4 long, and after that you have to use the same 50 ohm line, and we want this input impedance to be equal to 50 ohm, Zin dash to be equal to 50 ohm. So 180 should be converted to 50 ohm. So what will be the characteristic impedance of this line, Z naught dash of lambda by 4 line? To calculate that, we have to take Z naught dash equal to under root the load impedance for this line, that will be equal to the input impedance of this line, means 180 multiplied by 50 ohm. So this is 99,000 under root, which will give you approximately 90 square root will be 9.4 or 5 multiplied by 10, so it will be around 95 ohm. Exact calculation you can do. So this is the characteristic impedance. 95 ohm is the characteristic impedance of the lambda by 4 transformer. Now we are going to see how this 95 ohm will be used for the matching, so that we can reach at the center. So now this 3.6, we are at 3.6 point, and after denormalizing we are getting 180 ohm. See, if I normalize this 180 ohm with respect to 95 ohm, it will give almost 2, 95, 180 divided by 95, so it will come around 2, little bit lesser than 2. So this point can be shifted as this point here, approximately here. After that, what we have to do? We have to take a constant VSWR circle for lambda by 4 line. So this part will be lambda by 4 line. So only lambda by 4 circle we are going to draw. That means from this point to this point. So half circle will be the lambda by 4 movement. So this is how we are going to move. Now, once you reach at this point, and if you multiply with 180, multiply with 95, that is the characteristic impedance of the lambda by 4 line, you will get equal to 50. So whatever value you are getting, this multiplied by 95 will be equal to 50. That means if you divide 50 again with 50, you will go to the center. So movement is to this. So once you reach center, that means input impedance is 1 plus J0 and the lines are matched. Okay. So I am going to just repeat this. Load impedance, read the value of wavelength towards generator. It is 173 lambda. From there, you have to move it to the line where resistance is, reactance is 0. So on this line, you have reactance is 0. So the first point is at this point, that is 3.6. It is cutting at 3.6 and the wavelength value is 0.25 lambda. So the length required to make the load impedance purely resistive is 0.25 lambda minus 0.173 lambda. So this length is 0.077 lambda. That is the length requirement. Once you reach at this point, there will be some discontinuity in the line. Means you are going to use another characteristic impedance line. So this must be denormalized and again normalized. So if you denormalize it, you will get 3.6 multiplied by 50, 180 ohm. And if you normalize it with the characteristic impedance of the lambda by 4, you will get some other point. But both the points shows the same value. After that, you have to draw a constant VSWR circle from this point to this point. That means lambda by 4. Because you have lambda by 4 term. Once you reach here, again you have to denormalize with the lambda by 4 characteristic impedance and then normalize with the 50 ohm line. So you will reach at center. So this point and this point represents same value. This will also give you 50 ohm. This will also give you 50 ohm. That means you have reached center and your load is matched. Input impedance is matched now. And the for the calculation of the characteristic impedance, you will be using this formula. So in this formula, you can see under root 180. 180 is the input impedance at the load end and the 50 ohm is input impedance. So if you multiply and take a square root of this, you will get the characteristic impedance of lambda by 4. So this is how you can match. There will be three sections: first section, second section, and this third section. In first section, you have VSWR, which is equal to 3.6. In second section, VSWR will be different, that is around 2. And in third section, VSWR will become 1, that means it is matched. Once VSWR achieve value of 1, it is matched. Thank you. We'll be explaining you the LC matching in next lecture.